Does it feel like the one getting punched every time Google releases an update? Well, we better have our guts up, otherwise we'll be punched again because Google just dropped the helpful content update. We're gonna talk about what this update entails, how to prevent your website from getting punched, and how to get back up if Google lands a punch on it. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, and we have constantly been providing you with the most updated knowledge and tools with regards to SEO. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, we hope you do so. And if this video provides value to you, do help us a little by smashing the thumbs up button. First and foremost, if your site contains educational materials, entertainment, product reviews, and tech-related content, you might find your site impacted by this. But let's first talk about who shouldn't be worried about the update. Now, if you have been doing everything right, which means you are focused on creating content that satisfies a search intent, and your entire site has a clear site structure and is meant to serve a particular group of people. So if your site is about barbecue and you have been writing lots of content that are useful to people searching for barbecue knowledge and tools, or if your site is about teaching people how to play guitar and your site is about creating content that serves the needs of your audience, then you'll be fine. Even if you're using AI writers. Okay, there's a huge debate going on about this update, and it seems that this entire update revolves around punishing people using AI writers. If you look through the document, you'll see sentences like, part of a broader effort to ensure people see more original, helpful content written by people, for people in search results? Or are you using extensive automation to produce content on many topics? Or are you mainly summarizing what others have to say without adding much value, which most AI writers do? Or does your content promise to answer a question that actually has no answer, such as suggesting there's a release date for a product, movie, or TV show when one isn't confirmed? Most AI content writers typically spit out this gibberish. All these seem to be targeting site owners using AI writers. So Jack, why do you say otherwise? Let me give you a scenario. If you are an expert in a topic and you are using an AI writer to assist with your writing, and you are fact-checking, you're editing the content spat out by the AI writer, and you're adding your knowledge and experience in the content, and you are ensuring that the entire content is serving the search intent well, then it's fine to use an AI writer. But the problem comes when you rely heavily on the AI writer and publish content without proper research or even fact-checking. You may have enjoyed some success if that's you, but Google is coming after you. That's basically the summary, and all the things mentioned in this update have been said many, many times if you have been paying attention. So if it happens that this update hits your site, we want to share with you the steps to fix it and get back into the game, so stay tuned. But now, let's dive into the details of this update. As you know, Google wants content creators to write original and helpful content. It wants you to focus on people's first content, which means your content is written for people before it is optimized for search engines. The key is for people searching for something on Google to have a satisfying experience. And to do that, you have to follow their long-standing advice, where they will tell you what constitutes as a high-quality site, which they have said time and time again. So this is nothing new. And also the webmaster guidelines, which have been there for the longest time. So there's nothing new in this update. It is just that Google is introducing this update as a ranking factor to improve the search quality they have been promising their users for a long time. If you are new to SEO and content creation, you may want to take some time to read the long-standing advice and the webmaster guidelines. And to speed up your learning process, we have previously created this video, which might be helpful to you. The video is right up top. We have left the link in the description. Now, to know if your site will fare well on this update, is to answer this series of questions. I'm not gonna go through every single line, you can do it on your own, but let me highlight the important ones. Does your content clearly demonstrate first-hand expertise and a depth of knowledge? For example, expertise that comes from having actually used a product or service or visiting a place. This is in line with the search quality rater guidelines that deal with your money, your life topics, and the expertise, authoritativeness, and trustworthiness, in other words, EAT. If you want to check out this document, we have left a link in the description. Alternatively, this is the link. But generally, if you are a medical professional talking about medical topics, if you are a tech expert talking about tech topics, if your hobby is gardening and you are giving tips on gardening, if you are a professional photographer teaching people how to use a camera, if you are reviewing a particular camera model, make sure that you own a camera so that you can give a relevant review. If you are a social media manager advising people on how to grow their businesses on social media channels, you get the idea. There's so much content on the web already. The last thing Google wants is to rank content written by someone who doesn't know what they're talking about. That's the general idea. So if you have been hiring writers without assessing their knowledge and expertise, or using AI writers without fact-checking, they go against the guidelines. Now, the rest are what I've covered earlier. You can go through them on your own. And Google has given a list of questions. And if you answer yes to some or all of the questions, it is a warning sign that you should reevaluate the contents across your site. But in general, it is the opposite of what I've said earlier about doing things right. For example, this talks about not having a focused target audience, using AI writers without care, not having the searcher's intent in mind, do not know what you are talking about. But two things I would like to highlight. Number one is, are you mainly summarizing what others have to say without adding much value? In other words, content curation. For example, topics like best restaurants to eat in Singapore, site A listed 5, site B listed 3, and you wrote about 8 restaurants that site A and site B talks about. So you are not adding more value, you are just curating. That's unless you have included images of you visiting the restaurants, talking about your experience with each restaurant, how the food tasted, and if it suits a certain type of people who have a distinct taste, and all that kind of stuff. The key is to provide additional value to what is already out there. That's what Google is looking for. And the next thing I would like to further elaborate is this. If somebody searches for something and lands on your page, spends some time reading your article, goes back to Google and does further research, it is going to send a bad signal as it implies that your content does not meet the searcher's intent. But in the same scenario, when somebody lands on your page, consumes your content, and visits another page of your website, it's going to send a good signal to Google. In a while, I'm going to show you how to improve the quality of your content methodologically. But now, let's look into how the update works. So this update could take up to 2 weeks to complete, and it is a site-wide signal. So it is not a page-specific ranking signal. The signal will identify content with little, low added value, or is otherwise not helpful. And if your site has a high amount of unhelpful content, your overall ranking across the entire site may be affected. And it says here that removing unhelpful content could help the rankings of your other content. We'll talk more about how to tackle this in a while. And they further stated that if your site is affected, you have a chance of getting back to the game, but it may take some time. This is not a manual action nor a spam action, so you won't see any warnings from your search console. And this currently impacts English searches and may apply to other languages in the future. So with a clear understanding of what this update is and how it works, let's tackle it to either prevent your site from getting hit or fix your site to get back into the game. Now, as I've said earlier, if you have been following Google's guidelines, you shouldn't be worried about this update, but if it happens that your site is punished, here's what you can do. Since Google recommends removing unhelpful content, we've got to identify what constitutes unhelpful content. You can visit your Google Search Console for the same information, but what I'm going to share with you now will be more convenient and helpful for RankMath Pro users. If you have installed the RankMath Free and Pro version, make sure that you have this analytics module toggled on, and that you have connected your site to Google Search Console and Analytics. If you haven't done so, you can follow the steps through this link. Once you have connected your site to your Google properties, click on the Analytics module, and there you will see your Search Console and Analytics data in one place. Now you want to expand your site's data points to the past 6 months, and then go to the SEO Performance tab. Here, you can monitor if your site is punished or rewarded by an update. I'm recording this before the update, so we have to keep track of the data movements of this site. As we scroll below, you will see the performance of the individual pages. We want to sort the data by the number of clicks in ascending order, Now the clicks and impressions are the important columns to look at. If there are low clicks, below 10 to 60 clicks over 6 months, with low search impressions, this could signal that there is either a very low search demand, or the article is not ranked anywhere near page 1. In that case, you may want to consider deleting those articles, such as this. We can see that it ranks on the first page, but there are low impressions and no clicks. So to delete this article, you need to create a redirect. Copy the page link, go to the redirections module, add a new redirect, paste the copied URL, select the 401 content deleted option. You do not want to redirect this page back to the homepage or any random article, as that does not serve the purpose of the user's intent. So this is the appropriate option. You want to add that redirection. Now in another case, for example, we see that there are impressions, we are not getting any clicks, but you know that there is another content you have written that is very closely related to this article. In that case, you will want to do a permanent redirect to the other page. Add a new redirect, put the page link that is not fetching any clicks, add the page that is closely related. In this case, I know that the content of this article is closely related, so I want to permanently move this page to this to enhance the quality of my site. And another scenario is, there are little to no clicks, but with impressions, you will want to improve the content. Now, I will show you how to improve the content. The first step is to click on this entry, and it will show you all the keywords this article is ranking for. If you do this on Google Search Console, it might take you a while to sort and match the keywords to the page. So if you're not using Rank Math Pro yet, you might want to consider using it. Now, you need to be a little analytical here. Think about the search intent of each keyword here, and read through your article to see if it is answering the search intent of each keyword. Most of the time, it is not going to be the case. So you have to optimize the content to serve the intent of these keywords your article is ranking for. That's one of the methods. The other easy method to improve your overall content quality is to use Content AI. This AI tool is available for you as long as you are a Rank Math user. So even if you use the free version, you'll get full access. To use Content AI, on your WordPress editor and on Rank Math's tab, you will see the Content AI button here. If you have added your focus keyword, you will see it automatically added as you click on the Content AI button. As you hit the Research button, our AI system will analyze the contents that are ranked on your focus keyword, and it will suggest to you the word count you should use, the number of internal and external links to add to your article, the quantity of each heading tag, the number of images and videos to add, the keywords you should use in the content and its quantity. This should give you an indicator of what you should add to improve your content's quality, the keywords to use in the headings, the related questions to answer in the FAQ format, and external links to add so that Google will understand your content much better. Content AI runs on a credit system. As a free Rank Math user, you'll get 5 free credits. If you run out of it, buy more credits. It is not expensive anyway. If you divide it out for 50 credits, 1 credit is 38 cents. This is 32 cents per credit, and this is 22 cents per credit. If you want an in-depth tutorial on how to properly use Content AI to maximize the credits and improve your content quality, you can check out this video that is popping up right here. The link is in the description. All in all, nothing is new in this update. It is just that Google is improving its search ranking signals so that its users will see more relevant content ranking at the top. If you have been following the guidelines all along, you shouldn't be worried about this update. But if your site happened to be hit by it, it's time for you to reassess your entire content strategy as a whole. Does it have a good site structure? You may want to check out this video about creating a silo structure for your website. Are your content answering to the searcher's intent? Are you fact-checking or showing expertise in your content? And if your content provides added value to those already ranking at the top? If you can work on those items, you'll eventually see your site climbing back into the ranks in a couple of months. So hang tight and work hard on improving content that matters to your site. Anyway, if you find this video helpful, hope you can smash that thumbs up button. And if you want to get the most up-to-date SEO knowledge and tools, remember to subscribe to our channel. Do leave a comment down below and let us know if this update has hit you and what you are doing to get back in the ranks. We'll gladly assist you if you need our help as well. Thanks for watching this video. I'll see you in the next video.